You recall that in the first reading tonight, God was making a covenant with Abram, too soon to be called Abraham. And notice that he took several animals and said to split them in two and then to walk between them as a sign of the covenant. And that was the way they did covenants in those days. And what it would say is that I'll be faithful to the promises that I make to you and you make to me. And if I do not, then may I have the same fate as these animals that are split in two. But then the darkness comes and Abraham is in the total darkness, and then a light appears, a flaming torch, bright and white. Fire and light in the Old Testament was a sign of the presence of God, and the light goes through the dissected animals. God is saying, this is my covenant, and I will be faithful to this covenant forever. God was constantly making promises to mankind, because he wants us to be faithful to him and he will be faithful to us. Just before the gospel reading tonight, a few days before, Jesus had explained to Peter, James, and John and the other apostles that he was going to be tortured and die on the and be raised on the third day. They heard it, but they didn't understand it. They didn't grasp it. And so to prepare them for this horrible thing that would happen, he transfigures himself before them. And they see this wonderful vision of Jesus, his clothes all dazzling white. His whole body is glorified. He's showing them his resurrected body, transfigured before them. It's a glimpse of what it's going to be like after he rises from the dead. And so he's showing it to them because he knows what they're going to go through. And he wants them to be prepared that when they go through the suffering of Calvary with him, that they will be able to remember this scene, that there's hope above, beyond that. And he offers it to us too. Notice that the apostles were walking with Jesus every day. They were eating with him. They were listening to him. They still had a hard time understanding everything he was saying. It was so otherworldly, actually. And that's why they were having a difficulty. Jesus is trying to prepare them so that they one day will be able to grasp it fully. And the Lord is the same way with us. He wants us to grasp more fully who he really is, the Son of God. Lent is a time when we're called to really reflect on that reality, that Jesus truly is the Son of God. And then we have to hear those same words from the Father that they heard in the dark cloud on the Transfiguration. This is my beloved Son, listen to him. Listen to Jesus. And so how do we listen to him? Right now in this church, we're listening to him. In the prayers that we offer, the songs that we sing, in the words that we hear in the Holy Scriptures, in his body and blood that we receive in the Eucharist, we have the opportunity to listen to him. And so Lent should be a time when we open our hearts, our eyes, and our ears more to listening to Christ. We're celebrating St. Patrick's Day this weekend, and it is our patronal feast. We are so blessed to have St. Patrick as our patron. And you know the story of his life. He was captured by pirates from Ireland who were pagans, and he was hauled off there and he became a shepherd, forced into labor. And it was very, very difficult for him. He suffered a lot from hunger, from being alone, from bad weather, from brigands trying to capture the sheep, all the things he suffered. And during that time of that suffering, that's when he had a great conversion. That's when he turned to God for help and developed every day. He just started praying to God. He hadn't done that before. And by that prayer every day, he came closer to Christ. With God's grace, he was able to escape and he went to Britain where he continued his studies. In his heart, he always wanted to go back to Ireland and convert the pagans. He studied, became a priest. He was a bishop at the age of 43. And when it was announced that Rome was going to send him to Ireland, many other bishops objected because they thought that his education was defective. But the Pope was very wise in sending Patrick to Ireland. In a very short time, he converted the whole island by his preaching. He even converted kings and people in high power who gave him even greater ability to make the church grow there. And so he established dioceses, he ordained priests, he started churches and monasteries, schools. He did everything that he possibly could to promote the faith in Ireland. Even beyond that, many of the Irish missionaries went to Europe and were responsible for Christianizing and evangelizing Europe, came from Ireland. St. Patrick was a great evangelizer. He was a man of humility. He depended upon God for absolutely everything. And he was a man of great courage, that with the help of God, he could accomplish great things. And so we have a great patron in front of us that we too need to depend upon God for all things. And in his breastplate of St. Patrick, he says that may the heart of Christ be in all those who encounter me. May he be in the eyes of all who see me, in the ears of all who hear me. He wanted everybody to know Christ through him. And so we have a great patron, and hopefully we'll continue to try to imitate him in this season of Lent. He's living out these words of the God the Father to the apostles. This is my beloved son, listen to him. Patrick listened to Christ, and he accomplished great things. And you and I are the beneficiaries of the, who are the descendants descended from Ireland, our grandparents and great-grandparents who lived the faith and brought the faith to us. We're the recipients of a great heritage. So tonight we give thanks to God for the faith that's been handed on to us, and we ask the Lord to help us to see, what do you want us to do, Lord? What do you want us to do now? How can we continue to promote the faith? How can we re-evangelize when so many people that don't come to church, how can we bring them back? We need to first of all pray about it, and then we need to sit down and seriously talk about some ways that we can do that. So today we thank God for his word that comes to us in the scriptures, his deep love for us, and we also are grateful for the life and in the work of St. Patrick on our behalf.